was a different man in many ways tonight. And who can blame him? After the brutal beating, the brutal setup that not only Sting was a part of, but Roddy Piper, everybody in WCW, everybody in the Wolfpack was a part of, he comes out tonight. Face paint maybe peeling off a little bit, rubbing off from side to side. Yeah, the Wolfpack's in the house, and this is going to be quite a fight.
Some of them are in a bar beating up Scott Hall, so they're all over the place.
That's right. I wonder where that fight's going right now. Okay. It's going to go down, guys. The 5th of October, 1998, 20 days out from Halloween Havoc. One of our most memorable nights on many levels.
You know, I bet they keep fighting all the way to Indianapolis Thursday and Thunder. That'll be a great program.
You're not kidding, it will be. We're all going to be there. Join us at 8:05 on TBS for that event live at the Market Square Arena. And Bret Hart does come out. Remember the shellacking he got moments ago, living legend, on the hands of Sting?
Well, he can get a shellacking. I tell you one thing he can't do. He can't come out here and lie anymore. Nobody's going to fall for any nonsense coming out of the mouth of Bret Hart. He simply is the best liar there is, was, and will be. But now Sting is looking at the man and seeing exactly what he is and where is he going now.
He's going the opposite way is where he's going. I don't know if he wants to
I don't think he wants any part of that man.
He either doesn't want to or he wants to lure Sting out. A very subtle thing by Bret Hart. Bret Hart, during his years as a fan favorite, would bring his sunglasses to the ring, take them off, and give them to the fans. Now he takes them, puts them in the case.
This is the Wolfpack's out with Scott Hall. This isn't smart. He could be luring Sting in the back.
Sting has gone for it. Let's see. It is exactly what we anticipated. Wow, hello door, the steel door. Once again, how many times have we gone to the back here tonight for an unabridged brawl?
They're fighting all over town.
Sting, oh my goodness. Bret Hart finally gets a blow in and doesn't face Sting at all.
Look at the Hart's just staggered, he's trying to get his coat off.
The fight in the commons area, the cafeteria area back here. Once again, I guess the match hasn't officially even started.
But it's nowhere near the ring.
Well, the bell didn't sound, which means I guess this is the little pre-match fight we have going on here. At first, Bret Hart's trying to maneuver a table here. Oh, my goodness. Suplex Sting on a table, and he's not done yet. Oh, that's such a heavy trash can. Look at that. Oh, my goodness.
Bret Hart is one tough customer.
Yes, he is.
Sting should have waited in that ring.
That's exactly right. That's a very good call, Larry. Bret Hart nailed the side of the knee. And Bret Hart.
Oh, and on the Achilles.
Right on the Achilles tendon, you're right. That connects the calf with the ankle. That's such a vulnerable area. There have been many athletes in many different sports, career end. On a snapped Achilles tendon.
And he's closing that chair right on the leg. And
he's deliberately trying to break his leg.
He's deliberately trying to end his career is what he's trying to do. And he may have done it. He may have done it. The hatred has just gone too far. Sting got lured on the outside where Bret Hart could use many different devices. And as security tries to clear things in the back, You know, fans, I'm going to tell you, we're going to stay this and long with this as long as we can. I don't know when this is going to end. Oh. Not a bad move at all. Defensive one by Sting.
The only move he had.
Not quite a forklift, but it looked heavy enough.
And I'm not so sure Sting could even stand on his own power here. He hops up on his right leg. Yeah,
he's got no use to that left leg.
This is what it's come to. You are, in the last 2 weeks, have been witness to hatred as never before in our sport. Two men with the same move, mind you, used to win matches. They are back in our programming office, running people out.
That's no place to stay.
I think Sting's ahead on points.
Oh, he may. Hold on. Oh, that door frame does hurt.
They're going to go all night.
Yes, they are. It's going to take someone physically to get between these two and stop them.
Well, don't look at me.
I'm not looking at you. I'm looking at this monitor we're watching in sheer amazement.
Uh-oh.
He's
going to
run.
He's going to hit him with the truck.
He's going to try to run over him. Thank heavens the thing didn't start. Two of the most remarkable athletes ever, and it's come to this. And Sting has got the leverage here. Oh, my goodness.
Keep the weight on him.
Right across the elbow.
What was Bret Hart going to do when he tried to start that card up?
Well, he was going to try to run over the... Maybe try to put it in reverse and get out of there. It's Sting's version of the move. Scorpion Deathlock.
And he's got to sit down lower. He's got to sit down on it with his head up.
Oh, he's got that bad left leg. Don't forget that Bret Hart was trying to break him out a couple minutes ago.
He's not back far enough.
There you see him moving it.
You cheater.
Where's Hogan?
Hart's calling him a cheater. And he's begging for Hollywood Hogan. Sting just lets go, walks away.
What a fight.
Well, that one was nailed down. That means he'll try to find something else. Oh, no. Hart gets back up. Look out. Finally, security arrives. Where have they been?
Well, I think Dillinger went to get more help. He wasn't going to jump into it single-handedly.
You're right. You're right, Brain. You're exactly right. That's what happened. And the remnants, the carnage... That was this matchup, and as we said, we didn't expect to be a U.S. title bout. It was a fight. A fight that I can tell you right now, we have not seen the last of. What a night. A night that you experienced only on the number one wrestling program in the world, Nitro. Good night, everybody.